Dan Fitzgerald's Family Outdoor Adventures. Spanning the globe in order that all sportsmen and women, young and old, may experience our God-given gift, the great outdoors.
Hi folks, I'm Dan Fitzgerald, and I've been doing videos for about a decade now, and we've tried to do them to please as many people as we possibly can. There are a lot of categories of hunters. There's big rack hunters, small rack hunters, doe hunters, but in this video we're going to try and do something really different. It's amazing how much unity that you can get in your family if you take your whole family and get them involved in hunting. The wife, the daughters, the sons, let's get all of them involved in hunting. And in this production, we're going to try and do just that. This is a family outdoor adventure, and we're going to take all sizes of deer, and we're going to get as many people involved as we possibly can. So let's hit it. I'm coming from my living room to your living room. Let's do it.
Hey, wouldn't it be neat if Dan could just come out of the TV and join us right here? Would you guys like that?
Yeah.
Wow, it's cold out there.
Wow.
Hey, what's your name?
Yeah.
What's your name?
Leslie.
Boy, I tell you, it's cold out there.
Yeah.
Snowing. You watch our videos all the time?
Oh, yeah.
You like them?
Yeah.
You like to go on a hunt with us someday?
Yeah.
You too? You like to fish?
Yeah.
Yeah? Wait till you see the new fishing videos we're working on now. We need somebody to help us in those fishing videos. You know anybody that'd like to do that?
I do.
Yeah, you do. I love coming into your living room like this.
They'd love it.
Give me a hug before I leave. Oh, yeah. This is what it's all about right here. Future hunters of America. You're both going to be hunters, right?
Yeah.
All right. Well, I got to go. I'll see you next time.
Say bye.
Be fine.
Bye.
You know, a lot of folks ask me when I do shows and seminars, how you get so close to those deer like that? When you're hunting in the cornfield, there's a way to get real close. Check it out.
This program is meant to be both educational and entertaining for the entire family. Dan Fitzgerald Family Outdoor Adventures presents Whitetails Wild Style, featuring Dan Fitzgerald, veteran bow hunter for over 40 years, a man dedicated to his family and to educating and entertaining sportsmen worldwide. Guy Fitzgerald has traveled all over America crusading on behalf of hunting and fishing for the youth of our country. Greg Yarbrough, dedicated to bringing you the footage you expect from Dan Fitzgerald Productions, serving as both cameraman and hunter. This program is brought to you by these fine sponsors.
In the doghouse?
Man, where have you been?
Hey, Brian.
Last time I saw you, we were in Atlanta in August. You buck around and you said you needed to use my truck for a little while. It's November 15th. Man, where you been?
Well, I have a question. We want to try to do a Dynamite Alabama video down here. You have any designated areas where you have difference in trophy bucks and just...
What I'm gonna try to do is I've got one separate area that I call it non-trophy track land that we're gonna hunt one day on, depending on what kind of footage we've got on the other track. I've got most of my land, three out of the four tracks are strictly trophy buck hunting only. I don't let anybody shoot anything unless they're gonna mount it. But then a guy that wants to come here and shoot me will go hunt this other track of land.
Do you have a problem with us shooting any does?
No, you get a chance to shoot a doe. I mean, I've got doe tags. I've got doe tags from Game and Fish, and then the reason why that is there's so many deer in this area. Food sources, they're cutting out hardwoods, and there's a lot of pine trees, and I wanted to keep my deer in check as far as the numbers, and the only way you can do that is to take some of the does out. So, I'd be all more than happy to take some does.
That sounds good to me, hey?
One for you, one for
you. And how many deer can I shoot with this?
Two a day, a buck and a doe.
11:35 p.m. This makes me an official Alabama deer slayer, right?
That's right.
All right.
Has this ever happened to you? These are the things Dan covers in his seminars. You must overcome difficult situations to obtain success. We'll be right back. Notice where the arrow enters the deer in order to take out the vitals on the opposite side. More of what Dan covers in seminars. Complete pass-through shots are the most desirable. Just what Brian ordered.
What's for dinner?
We got some venison, we got some dead pig, and we got some green peppers, red bell peppers, pea pods, corn.
Is this why we hunt?
This is hunted down to kill before. Harvested.
Harvested. That was harvested.
That was killed.
That's vegetables. That was killed.
You got it. Yes, sir. You can't kill it.
What do you think of Bryan Camp, Macon County Guide Service?
Oh, man, this is awesome.
Nice place.
I'll tell you what, anybody that comes down here to hunt for a while, for anything you've got to kill, it's going to get hunted. One thing they're not going to do, they're not going to go away hungry, and they're going to be successful.
Lord, we thank you for this food. We thank you for this day and the opportunity. We thank you for the deer we were able to take here at Brian's. I pray you'll bless his business. Give us a safe trip to our next location. We give you all the praise and glory. In your name, amen.
Amen.
Hey, let's eat.
That's gonna be some grub.
I'm only polite when I'm praying.
Looks good, Chef.
What are you doing here, man?
Hey,
put the rice on the net on to it.
You got your chopsticks?
You want the rice?
Chopsticks.
Yeah, he got some chopsticks.
He's got his hippie band. Where's his chopsticks, man?
Hey. Brian's got it bad. He couldn't even stay off the phone 30 seconds.
After setting up for an afternoon hunt, Dan hopes to get a doe. But it looks like that ain't gonna happen. Oh well, looks like Greg is gonna be the hunter now. It's time to trade camera for bow.
Out there would give up a chance to shoot a buck like this one. That's what it's all about. That's the thrill, hunting with your buddies.
The grunting turned his head, but not his kill zone. Greg does not have a good shot from this angle, as he is above the camera. Not today, Yankee. You're not going to get my southern whitetail. Dan hit a perfect shot from his spot, but Greg is the hunter. You would never believe how many days like this go by. Ever wonder what your expressions look like on a day like this? That's it. Dan's wife, Kay, brought Guy to the airport.
Hey, we're going straight to camp. The guy's going to get his deer this afternoon.
My turn tonight, folks. Let's do it up.
Not much light left, but we got to try.
Checking the night, folks.
We got us a nice little deer here. Got the tag already on him. All you hunters need to do that, man. We are ready to eat this sucker.
You excited?
I can taste that in my mouth. Hey, I gotta tell you something. When I drew on that deer, and I put that pin on that shoulder, man, my mind was saying, man, you might as well kill yourself. You're going down. Confidence is the key, definitely.
Well, let's go eat it.
Yeah! Chow down.
All right. Chip off the old block right there. Hey, you ready to shoot a big buck now? Hey, you know what? It's cool. You shot a big buck, then a doe, then another big buck, then another doe. Zigzag back and forth.
Hey, a deer's a deer, man.
That's right.
I got as much shaking, my knees were knocking on that as an 8-point buck, folks. To do it.
Let's go eat that thing, man.
Practice.
Well, this is my bow case, my cutting table, you name it. Got a cooler, bucket of water. Guy's deer is all whacked up, getting ready to go in the cooler. You ready to go get another?
You better believe it, buddy.
Get this one put away. No. And we do have the tag. It's right here. Put that back on the cooler when we're done. Hey, it don't get no better than this. You ready to eat these straps?
Yes, sir.
Folks, this is a recovery. I love it.
Meet Anthony Clark. The strongest man in the world is on Dan's video team. Let's see if Guy provided enough meat.
I need to tell you, Guy shot this deer.
What? Yeah.
He shot, this was in the video.
It's coming up.
This is a mutton buck, a young buck. And it's coming out in the video that you're in. You're going to be eating the deer that you're in the video. You'll love it.
You never know the purpose of some kills. Mm-hmm, it's great.
You want to be in that video?
Oh yeah, definitely. I mean, I've seen the last one you had. And that was really great. It's really exciting when you're right there behind the bleachers. Look at that.
Next time you see Anthony in our video, he's going to be hunting hogs.
Yes.
I know Greg's dying to get over here on this. Come on.
Because he gets up.
Greg, I'm in the window. You can get that thing off me, Greg.
Hey, Greg.
Greg.
After Anthony gets done eating that, we're going to see if he can pull my bow.
Yeah.
what I like to see you do is hold the bow where you're going to shoot the animal.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of guys do it like this.
Yeah.
You start off by putting the bow where you want the arrow to go, and just reach and take your string and pull it back slow like that.
Okay.
And you draw my bow back. Now everybody watches knows how much power my bow's got. That's cranked up to well over 100 pounds.
Wow. That's pretty awesome.
You can pull that so easy. It's amazing.
That's pretty awesome.
That bow right there will drop just about any animal you put an arrow on an animal.
Wow.
That's an awesome bow right there.
That's awesome.
That's what you need, though, right there for hog hunting.
Sounds good to me. I'm excited about going.
Just give you want me to order it tomorrow?
Order it tomorrow. That'd be great.
Yeah.
I can't wait. That's going to be awesome.
Yeah,
and I noticed that you got, Lord, help me when I aim. That's pretty awesome.
That's what puts those arrows where
exactly.
They go.
Exactly. And it's nothing like the Lord being in there.
That's right.
Good. So just, pull like this.
Yep. You can hold that.
That's pretty awesome.
Well, I tell you what, I'm really proud to have you on my pro staff.
Oh,
I'm looking forward to a lot of years of good times with you.
Yeah.
And me and Anthony are getting ready to put a workout video together.
Yeah, definitely.
And it's going to be how to work out the proper way, right?
Exactly, proper way, and I think it's going to help other people. I mean, just like you said, I mean, power goes in this power and strength. I mean, the power of the arrow going as fast as it can to hit that animal, that's going to be pretty awesome, and developing that strength. And just being fit to shoot. Because
I'm excited.
Sounds like a good one, guys.
So when you feel good, you look good. If you look good, you feel good, right?
And you perform good.
Exactly, you perform well. Performance is the key.
It shatters on the world record time. 735 pounds of reverse kickback. He's also set an all-time. He's that world record by looking 2,465. With the power of God and the strength of Samson, we prove to the world the strongest man, the solid power of the Greek of all time.
Both Dan and Anthony tour the nation's schools, bringing the good news to America's youth. Day after day, Anthony performs in an effort to persuade each and every one of them to perform their very best at all times. With Anthony on the team, many more thousands of lives are sure to be touched. Anthony is an example of not limiting your goals. Let's make it a point to build each other up in all that we do. Everyone wants to be a winner, and that's the desire of this team.
It's Brian. How you doing, man?
Man, I can't believe it. I'm in a tree stand.
Man, you've got to get here to Alabama right now. Yesterday would have been too late.
What?
I mean, I know you're hunting right now. I know it's hot where you're at, but it cannot possibly be any hotter than where we're at right now. These white oaks are falling, man, and it is unbelievable what these deer are doing.
Brian. Man.
Hey, I tell you what. You need to get in the truck. You need to come on down here. This is the time to be in Alabama. These white oaks are hitting the ground. You can get as much footage as you possibly need.
Hey, you want to go to Bama? We're going to blow this hunt today anyway. Hey, Meek, we'll be there, man. We're getting out of the tree right now.
See you in about a day.
We'll be there. All right, man. See ya. Get that down here, man. Brian's waiting for us. Let's get out of here.
To get the pickup.
This is the pickup.
This is our Kenworth home away from home right here. This is a couch and a bed, man.
This is it.
Got a refrigerator in it. We ready to rock, Doc.
Looks like a cabin cruiser.
That's not a cabin cruiser. This is a cabin cruiser. Like action-packed fishing, check out our new fishing tape.
All right.
Guy is sure to entertain you.
That's good. Woo! 4 inches, legal's 37. It's on the wall, baby.
All right.
Guy has caught most species of game fish in the country.
Man, we gotta get rolling.
I'm depending on you and Perry. I don't know nothing about this Alabama deer hunting.
Well,
did you say you are or aren't a redneck?
He's redneck.
He dates a girl that chews, right?
No, I don't.
If you don't, I'll fix you up with one.
He dates more than chews now, I'll tell you. Spits,
spits, truth comes out.
Let's go kill some.
All right.
I'm going to
take him by the barbershop. Haircut.
No, you can't do that. Now, Holmes
is hiring. Yeah.
You're going to have a fight on your hands getting us to the barber.
That's right.
Hey, look at this, man. I'm catching up.
Man, my white tails. Halloween style.
Not every day produces the game. If it did, it wouldn't be much fun. All the more reason to keep trying. Dan is just about to make his shot on this little buck, but Greg shifted his weight and guess what happens? Whoa, we almost hit the dirt.
Man, we could have got him if the stand hadn't fell. That's scary.
This time, we'll try something different. Brian and Perry were elated to find Dan had taken a nice buck. The hard work had paid off.
I'm trying to get a body count.
That's a good one, bro.
We just shot him.
That's a big body deer.
Yeah, man! Man!
Congratulations.
Thanks, Perry. Brian.
There you go, buddy.
Hey, you're not going to believe this. Just before you came, I just shot this deer. He stood back there. All these deer were blowing up here. I sprayed another squirt of that vanilla killer. I'm not kidding. You can see all this on video. I sprayed another squirt
right
of it right there. One time, that dude ran right up, just like that. Ran right to us, just like that.
I tell you what.
That cool? Hey, that's why we didn't even go practice this morning, man.
We gotta have back straps for the front.
Hey, I want that cake. I got a real big wild rack mug to mount. I got a new cake. Man, that's a big body deer for
me. That'll work.
We can move that stand. Work.
Hey,
job,
baby. Glad I can help. Told you when you come to Alabama.
Wait till you see it, huh? Wait till they see it, huh? You on three.
Awesome.
On the run?
Cool.
That's great.
What did I tell you when I called you Friday? It was going to be good spot.
Hey, let me tell you what. What we need to do is just check out the footage and see how that happened up with Brian getting us down here. We're up in Michigan minding our own business in a stand, and Brian calls us. He's got these deer running all over around on his stand down here. And here we are, Alabama, the next day.
And the deer ain't running around no more.
Man, you popped him. Did that arrow hit him in the spine, or did it go in and just kind of pull?
Lunged
him.
Okay.
You sure did a lot right over.
Broke his shoulder. Broke all kinds of things, man. I knocked the snout out of him. He went right when I hit him. He just started rolling. He's rolled all the way from that tree to right here.
You pumped?
Yeah, man.
Cool. Right there.
That's the blood dragging out.
That's the way. I'll take that. All right. You guys want to go ahead and start headed out?
This is his purse right here.
We'll move the stand.
What's that?
That's your purse, right?
Yeah. That's my purse.
He's going to the shopping mall.
My hair's getting long enough, I need to wear a purse. Ready?
Dan's Holden Hall safety belt and game drag in action. You ask how we line up such good hunts? Check it out. All across America and Canada, hunting shows offer opportunities, and Dan and his team are there. There are a lot of good folks in the industry, ready and willing to help. And helping each other is what it's all about. Many magazines offer hunt ads. Outfitters and guides are in the business to help you. Dan lined up this hunt over the phone with outfitter Keith Wade. Dan is accompanied by world champion 3D shooter and very good friend Shannon Caudle.
Are you back in the boondocks or what?
We didn't think you guys would ever get here.
Hey, Dennis. Hey, Keith. Yeah, Keith. Dennis Wolverine owns Deer Dust. I'm going to see if Deer Dust works for us down here in this area.
Well, it's been tested time and time again. Again. So.
Well, Keith, I'm anxious to see your setup. You got a lot of land to hunt here. How many acres you got?
We got a little over 7,000 acres. We work with. We'd like to get more, but that's hard to do.
Yeah. Well, I'll tell you what, I'm ready to get right at it.
What's the name of the lodge?
Piney Woods Hunting Lodge.
Piney Woods Hunting Lodge. If you want to come hunting at Piney Woods Hunting Lodge, don't do it till you see this video. I'll let you know if it's any good. Put the pressure on, didn't it?
Yeah.
Well, what we got right here is we got some footage from one of my sponsors, Dennis Wilburn from Deer Dust. He took his home video camera out there and he's videoing his own hunt. Put down the deer dust, got in the tree stand, and like an hour or two later, the deer comes in. Dennis has got the camera mounted on his tree and he's trying to get it on the deer, and this didn't come together all that good, as you'll see. You can see the jump in there. He's trying to figure out if he wants to get the video or if he wants to shoot the deer. The last minute, he tries to shoot the deer and he doesn't get it good in the video, but it's pretty exciting, and I think you're going to like what happens in the end on this piece of footage. This is pretty exciting. I think you'll like this. But what I'd like to add is this is the kind of thing that we're looking forward to having you send in your home video footage for us, but just make sure you get the hit on the video. Send us your footage. We'd like to put it in our videos. I think you're going to like this. Let's check it out together.
Remember, this is a consumer camera like most.
I suppose you saw what happened. That buck, I couldn't tell how many points. He's kind of a non-typical buck. He came down. The wind was blowing from me to him. That deer does about 20 yards. You can't see completely what he's doing, but he just stops right in the deer dust, puts his nose in it several times, and he turns sideways, gives me the shot, and I just can't make the shot. I don't know what my problem is, but deer dust did the job.
Dennis missed the deer, but we're on the spot. Check this out. This deer ain't getting away. Can you believe that's the way to get a deer? Look at this. Man, that's a pretty good buck. About an 8-pointer. Can you believe that? I didn't see a buck from my tree stand today, but I ain't going home without a deer. Somebody could have got that deer, would have gone there alone and got a nice trophy. Good buck. I wonder if Dennis and those guys saw any deer today.
Man, you're not going to believe what I missed. Well, what?
Say what? I got my buck.
That's the one I missed a while ago.
No way. Get out of here.
Man.
Tell me about it.
Well, they come into the deer dust like usual and I just flat out missed him, Dan. I thought I had it on video, and I don't even have him on video.
Well, we got him on video now. Oh. You had your camera in the tree stand?
Yeah, I had it in the tree stand.
You didn't get any video of the deer?
I got a little bit of him walking in, but I got so nervous when he came on up there that I thought I had it on him. And took the shot instead of the video.
I tell you what, if you haven't missed a whitetail, you don't know what you're missing. But he still didn't get away.
We didn't miss this one.
Man, I tell you what, that thing come running right out in the middle of the road and just slammed on his brakes, looked straight at the front of the truck. I couldn't stop, man. It just, Jenny, that's a buck, and bam, that's too late then.
Can't meet anyway, huh?
I guarantee it. Well, as I said earlier in this program, that we're trying to build unity in hunters. And that's exciting for me, and I feel like I'm a crusader on behalf of hunting, and I'm going to go out and do my crusading. But we got a couple of pieces of footage here that I think you're going to enjoy. A couple of good friends of mine that are guides, and one's a taxidermist, and they got some good kills on video, and I think you're going to enjoy this. We look forward to seeing some of your kills. We are entertained when we see your kills when you send them in to us. We love that, and to me, I'd rather see someone else shoot a deer and me get to video it than to do it myself. So if you got some good kills on video, send them in to us. We'd enjoy that. But right now, let's check Pat out. He's going to do it for you.
Now, let's join Pat O'Neill as he takes one wild style. you'll see why he's smiling. Once again, notice where the arrow has to enter the deer to take out the vitals. Pat is a veteran hunter and guide with many trophies like this one. It is a trophy, isn't it? Pat's a happy camper.
You know, if you really want to find out how good a friend your hunting buddy is, tell him to take a video camera, give up one of his hunts to video you. I think that'll put a whole new emphasis on unity. Let's check out Perry now. Pat's going to video Perry. I think you'll enjoy this.
Perry is a very experienced hunter, guide, and taxidermist. Let's check him out.
Man, I'm excited about this next sequence. A good friend of mine, Joshua Miller, just shot an awesome buck down in Florida. You'll like it. He's real excited, and I'm real excited for him. It doesn't matter if you shoot a big rack or a small rack, though. It's still a deer buck. Man, I'm excited and pumped, and so is he. Let's check it out, man.
Maybe they come in here like they did yesterday when we're doing business. We'll be ready this time.
Lemuel is a very experienced bow hunter and an excellent teacher. He is doing his part in helping America's youth get on the right track and stay there for life. Lemuel uses BK by the case. Folks, this is the way it's meant to be, a father and son or daughter.
a nine point with this sticker.
And he's broke half of it off, looks like, yes. Broke off at the base.
Man,
what do you think?
I like it.
I reckon you do like it. Woo-wee. Good, not a lie. That's a Florida buck, and a good one. He looks to me like he'll score about 1.8, 1.10, something like that. Ooh, son. My goodness. Dads, get your boy and go hunting. He doesn't get, this is a bigger thrill for me than it is for him. And when you take your son out there or daughter out there and they do what he's just accomplished or even come close, you're going to understand what I'm talking about. Man, I was shaking for him. I got buck fever worse than he did. Did you get buck fever? Nah. Yeah, he told me, he said, I couldn't breathe. Man, oh man, what a day. It don't get much better than that. Congratulations, bud. I love you.
Man, that's got to be a take. We got more footage in this thing than we ever dreamed of putting in this video. But we've had a great time. We've met a lot of people, traveled a lot, been in a lot of states. I feel like we've accomplished a lot, and we've got a lot of unity. We've met a lot of you guys out there personally, and that's exciting to me. You know, the photos, we love these photos that come in, and we love hunting with everybody. I wish I could hunt with everybody in this country, but it's just not really that possible. But keep those letters coming, keep those photos coming. We really love that. And just remember, we're all on the same team. We're going back down to Alabama, and we're going to eat some wild boar and some deer down there. And that's what hunting is all about. We don't have to kill something every time we go out there. Just have a good time, meet friends, have that camaraderie, and have those memories. And get involved with those kids, too. That's the thing that I'm excited about. Just remember this. If you take a kid hunting, chances are you won't be hunting for that kid.
Bad, bad as bone right here. Man, we got that dude cleaned off.
Everybody getting filled up?
Oh, yeah. I can see.
This is what you call eating wild style. When I ask my, when I say my prayers over this meat, I'm thank God I ain't this piece of meat. You know, you hear a lot of stories about Alabama's deer only weighing 20 pounds and all that stuff. They got 20 pound racks. There's some good deer here in Alabama. How much you charge to come down here, huh?
$3.25
a day. $3.25 a day, all the hog you can eat.
Yeah.
Guaranteed to kill a buck like this every day.
Careful now.
That's you if you are. Got a green that's Suburban that's and know how to drive. A green Suburban, know how to drive.
Where's that paper you signed?
Hey, this is wild style right here, Alabama, with all these rednecks. And then you know what? They like to be called rednecks.
That's right. Main thing we enjoyed having you come to the 4-Hour Hunting Club. Hey, big man. Wilson eat with us.
We had a good time. Well, I'm done eating, and I got to go back to Michigan. Somebody let me borrow this truck. I'll be right back.
Hey, man.
Hey, this is Brian Thomas. Don't let it go.
No way.
Hey, he's never bringing that truck back.
No,
never get it back.
Yeah. Hey, let's go rabbit hunt.
That's all I can hit.
Want to see a rabbit video? Send in your requests. After all, we got to do something between big game hunts.
Did you get that?
That's how I shoot my bow. Santa just told me how to do that. I didn't aim or nothing. Huh?
I want y'all to know that's the only two Dan has hit this whole time.
Where do you want me to shoot him at? Right out there?
Yeah, that's fine.
Whoa.
Good shooting.
Thank you, thank you. Get up there, Jackie.
Do anything for a bone.
Ain't no bone left.
Pull.
Good job. Nice shooting.
Good Thank shooting. You, man. Thank you. Let's go shoot some of them flying things.
Yeah,
let's
hit some flyers.
Man, that's a father and son that's tough to beat.
Boom!
Alright! There they are. You guys are bad.
That's how you keep your kids straight.
That's bad.
Hey, man.
Good shoot, Chip.
Thank you, man.
Hey, now we're gonna go kill some deer with a bow and arrow. Don't put that in there.
You guys gotta teach us how to do this stuff.
Takes practice, man.
A lot of practice.
Hey, we've had a good time.
Hunting show promoters in every part of the country work hard year-round to assure their shows have something special for the entire family. You can book your hunt with the same outfitters who take Dan and his team hunting.
Well, I tell you what, I'm happy to be here at the Dixie Deer Classic in Raleigh, North Carolina. I got Bobby here with the New River Bow Hunters, and Lloyd, and Bernie Prim. I'll tell you, these are a fine group of guys right here. They're real involved in working with the kids. I was blessed to go down to their function last year, and we raised, what did we raise, $3,500? $3,500 for the Children of Miracle Network. And these guys are on fire for the kids. And I'm really looking forward to coming down there and doing that again this year, Bobby.
That's right, man. It's for the kids.
He looks like a bow hunter.
Yeah,
let me ask you, Jacob, have you ever killed a deer yet?
No.
You want to?
Yeah.
What are you going to do with it when you get it?
I don't know.
You going to eat it? All right, let's see how you do. You're a good-looking bow hunter. Good shooting.
How would you like to go on a hunt of a lifetime? Dan Fitzgerald and you, one-on-one hunting adventure. Let Dan guide you on a one-on-one hunting quest of a ferocious wild boar. Experience the most exciting and challenging wild boar hunt ever offered. Choose your weapon and get ready for a dynamite, get-down, action-packed, heart-pounding hunting adventure beyond your wildest dreams. This chance of a lifetime includes two nights lodging, an evening with Dan, head mount by one of our world-class taxidermists, enlarged personally autographed photo of yourself, Dan, and your trophy. A copy will also be displayed in Dan's lodge. Your hunt will be videotaped by one of Dan's professional cameramen. Dan will personally assist you in processing your meat. You may be featured in Dan's newsletter. You will be eligible to be in a future Dan Fitzgerald video production and cover. You will receive a Successful Hunter t-shirt, hat, and certificate. Dan will personally contact successful applicants. A percentage of the proceeds go to charitable organizations. Only a very limited number of hunters can be accommodated. So first come, first hunt. Serious inquiries only. You snooze, you lose. Remember, keep those letters and photos coming in. We encourage you to send us your personal hunting video footage. We will select a few of the best for our future videos. All pictures, letters, and video footage become the property of Fitzgerald Hunting Enterprises Incorporated.